Children, let us study the concept of buoyant force. The upward force acting on the object in water or other fluid or gas is called buoyant force. Buoyant force depends on two factors. Number one, volume of the object. The buoyant force is more if the volume of dipping object is more. Number two, density of liquid. More the density of liquid, more is the force of buoyancy. Let me tell you an activity, and you can do this activity at home. Take a small bucket, fill it completely with water, and then dip this bucket in a large bucket containing water. Try to lift small bucket with its handle out of water. You will feel the weight of bucket less when it is completely immersed in water than when it has been pulled out of water. Why is it so? The buoyant force due to a fluid is proportional to the density of the fluid. The density of water is much greater than that of air. Therefore, the buoyant force acting on a bucket full of water while it is in water is much greater than that when it is out of the water. Hence, it appears to weigh less while it is in water than when it has been pulled out of water. One more practical application of buoyant force is, an iron nail sinks in water, but a ship made from iron floats on water. The reason is, an iron nail sinks in water because its density is more than that of water. A ship made from iron, due to the particular shape given to it, displaces a large amount of water so that the buoyant force acting on the ship due to water balances the weight of ship. Hence, the ship floats on water. It becomes easier to swim in sea water than in fresh water. This is because the density of sea water is higher than the density of fresh water due to salts dissolved in sea water. Is it clear to you? How is it decided that an object left in liquid will get sink in the liquid, will float on the surface, or will float inside the liquid? The object floats if the buoyant force is larger than its weight. The object sinks if the buoyant force is smaller than its weight. The object floats inside the liquid if the buoyant force is equal to its weight. Children, watch the activities which will help you all to understand the concept of buoyant force clearly. Children, I am going to explain you the concept of buoyant force. For this, I have taken a potato and two beakers. One beaker is filled with water and another beaker is filled with salty water. Let us see. When I keep this potato in plain water, what will happen? Potato sinks because here weight of potato is more than the buoyant force. Now let me explain you what is buoyant force. Buoyant force is the force which is exerted in upward direction. Here, due to gravity, the potato sinks. Gravitational force is more as compared to buoyant force. But when this potato is kept in the salty water, let us see what will happen. The water is salty because of dissolved salts. Here, upward force, that is buoyant force, is more as compared to plain water. And here the upward force and force due to gravity are balanced, and that's why the potato floats inside the water. Buoyant force depends upon two factors. Number one, volume displaced by the object, and number two, density of liquid. Here, density of salty water is more than plain water. Buoyant force increases as the density increases. Potato is floating inside the water. Children, today we are going to study the concept of density. You all know density is mass per unit volume. See, these are the wooden blocks. If I put them into a tub containing water, they will float because the density is less. The object whose density is less, it will float. And the object whose density is high, that object will sink. This is a object made up of iron. When I put this into water, it will sink. So, the object whose density is less, it will float. And the object whose density is high than water, it will sink. This is a plastic spoon. Let us see what will happen. If I put this plastic spoon into water, it will float because density of plastic spoon is less. But if I keep this stainless steel spoon into water, it will sink because stainless steel has greater density than water. If I put a empty plastic bottle into the tub containing water, it will float. And this is an aluminium foil. Let me crumble it and I am throwing it into the tub containing water. Let us see what will happen. It is going in downward direction and it is floating underwater. Now if I keep this container which is made up of aluminium foil, let us see what will happen. The container will float on the surface of water. See, crumbled paper of aluminium is floating inside the water and the aluminium container is floating on the surface of water. Why is it so? This container has density less than water, so it floats. And here, in the case of crumbled piece of aluminium foil, the buoyant force and the force due to gravity are balanced. So, it is floating inside the water. Thank you.
Children, today I am going to show you how buoyant force depends upon the nature of liquid. For that, a stone is tied to the spring balance. And you can see the weight of stone is 50 gram. Keep this stone in different liquids. Let us try first in water. The weight is 35 gram. How did it happen? In water, buoyant force is exerted on the stone and it acts in upward direction. So, the weight of stone is less as compared to weight of stone in air because of buoyant force. Now let us see the weight of stone in oil. Weight of stone in oil is 40 gram. Oil is less dense as compared to water. Density of oil is less than density of water. So, less is the density, less will be the buoyant force. So, here the weight is 40 gram. Now, let us try the weight of stone in salty water. Salty water is having high density, that's why the weight of stone is only 32 grams. So density increases due to dissolved salt and buoyant force is maximum in salty water. So buoyant force depends on two factors. Number one, volume displaced by the object, and number two, density of liquid. So salty water has highest density than water and oil. Therefore, the weight of stone is minimum in case of salty water. Thank you.
A glass bowl is kept into the tub containing water. The glass bowl is floating on the surface of water, and 3/4 part of it is submerged into the water. Now I am putting some colored pebbles into this glass bowl. When I put pebbles into this glass bowl, its weight increases. Force of gravity acts in downward direction and buoyant force acts in upward direction. In this case, when the glass bowl is floating inside the water, both the forces, force due to gravity and buoyant force, are balanced. Let us see how much weight of pebble this glass bowl can hold. The weight is increasing and still the bowl is floating inside the water. The bowl has sunk into the water. The glass bowl has sunk into water. Here the density of glass bowl with pebble has increased than water, so it has sunk. Thank you. Write down the observation of each activity in your science practical copy. Thank you.